I've only been in Congress since January of this year, and on the very first day of my swearing in, a Democrat in my class called for the impeachment of the president on day one, using much more colorful language than I would ever use. Since then, this committee focused on the Mueller report and the Russia collusion theory. We all sat and listened to Mr. Mueller state unequivocally that there was no evidence that the Trump campaign colluded with Russia. So that didn't work for the Democrats. So they then changed their talking points and moved to the obstruction of justice theory, that the president obstructed justice. Then that fizzled. Then after coordinating with Chairman Schiff's staff, a whistleblower filed a complaint based completely on hearsay and overhearing other people that weren't on a phone call talk about a phone call between two world leaders, which led to the Intel Committee so-called impeachment inquiry, which violated all past historical precedent, denied the president basic due process rights and fundamental fairness by conducting the so-called inquiry in secret without the minority's ability to call witnesses, and denied the president the ability to have his lawyers cross-examine witnesses, a right afforded to President Clinton and every defendant in our justice system, including rapists and murderers. The Republicans on this committee have repeatedly requested all evidence collected by the Intel Committee. As we sit here today, we still don't have the underlying evidence that we've been requesting. Again, a right afforded every criminal defendant in the United States. So instead, we sit here getting lectures from law professors about their opinions, not facts. I guess the Democrats needed a constitutional law refresher course. The Republicans don't. Mr. Chairman, you have acknowledged, and I quote, the House's, quote, power of impeachment demands a rigorous level of due process. Due process means the right to confront witnesses against you, to call your own witnesses, and to have the assistance of counsel. Those are your words, Mr. Chairman, not mine. What are you afraid of? Let the minority call witnesses. Let the president call witnesses. Clinton alone called 14 witnesses to testify. Let the president's counsel cross-examine the whistleblower. Let the president's counsel cross-examine the intel staff who colluded with the whistleblower. In your own words, those are the rights that should be afforded to the president. Rights every criminal defendant is afforded. Even terrorists in Iraq were afforded more due process than you and the Democratic majority have afforded the president. I know, because I served in Iraq, and I prosecuted terrorists in Iraq, and we provided terrorists in Iraq more rights and due process in the Central Criminal Court of Iraq than you and Chairman Schiff have afforded the president of the United States. No collusion, no obstruction, no quid pro quo, no evidence of bribery, except opinion, no evidence of treason, no evidence of high crime or misdemeanors. We have a bunch of opinions from partisan Democrats who have stated from day one that they want to impeach the president, and not on this theory, but on multiple other different theories. The American people are smarter than your ABCs of impeachment that you've had on the screen that were laid out today. And it's extremely demonstrative of your lack of evidence, giving you called law professors to give their opinions and not fact witnesses to give their testimony today to be cross-examined and the rights afforded to the President of the United States. Mr. Chairman, when can we anticipate that you will choose a date for the minority day of hearings? Mr. Chairman, I'm asking you a question. When can we anticipate that you will choose a date for the minority day of hearings?
The gentleman is recognized for the purpose of questioning the witnesses, not for colloquy with colleagues.
Well, then I'll do that after my time. I yield the remainder of my time to Mr. Ratcliffe.